It's just a fantastic situation to stand on the shoulders of giants.
It really lays the foundation for quantum information science today. Things like quantum entanglement, it's not a bug of nature, but actually a feature.
Clauser's story is actually few people believed it was worthwhile work.
We can use them to do interesting things that we can't do classically, and it's just the beginning.
The Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences has this morning decided to award the 2022 Nobel Prize in Physics in equal share to Alain Aspin, John F. Clauser, and to Anton Zeilinger.
So what did Clauser actually do in the experiment? He figured out a way how to create entangled photon pairs and then measured very carefully the correlations of polarization states in pairs of photons, which then allowed him to show that Bell's inequality is broken. And indeed, quantum mechanics features entanglement and non-locality. All light that's all around us is made out of light particles. And these particles of light, those are photons.
If you have two light particles, they can be entangled, meaning that even if they're very far away from each other, opposite ends of the universe maybe, the information in these particles can be linked in ways that can't be explained by classical physics.
So basically, photons can wiggle in different ways. They can wiggle this way, or they can wiggle that way. And that is called polarization. So you can have horizontal or vertical polarization for a photon. And now, as photons are quantum particles, they cannot only wiggle in one direction, but they can wiggle in both directions at the same time. This property of polarization, horizontal and vertical polarization between two photons, can be extremely strongly correlated, such that when one photon is in the vertical polarization, the other one is going to be bound to be in the horizontal polarization and vice versa. And this is a very powerful property of photons that makes them suitable for tests of entanglement and also for use in quantum information applications.
There are a lot of exciting possibilities for using quantum information.
As in classical information, where you use bits that are either zero or one.
In quantum information, the basic unit is a quantum bit or a qubit. And a qubit can be more complicated. It can be zero or one, or zero and one at the same time, or somewhere in between.
My work is basically trying to control quantum systems to a level that you can actually create such superposition states.
One day we hope to build large-scale quantum computers with millions or billions of quantum bits or qubits.
And with this evolution comes the ability to use these quantum systems actually for technological applications.
But the only way that these computers will be able to do what we hope they can do is if all of these qubits are entangled in this delicate way. This Nobel Prize is really honoring the first steps towards that. You know, they got two particles entangled and showed what you can do with it. And hopefully in the future, we'll be able to get millions of them entangled.